What is up, guys? Welcome to Ain't Nothing Behind. Today, we're just going to be teaching you how to pass the first three bucket list events. I'm going to be doing this for the whole bucket list, so you know you can stay tuned for that. But today, we're going to be talking about the first three. So, the first one, as you can see here, it's near the Horizon Festival. You're in the Koenigsegg, the difficulty is easy, and you are told to drive it like you stole it. Now, this basically means you go to the spot on the map at over 125 miles per hour, or whatever, you know, units you use. And it's a very, very simple, easy, you know, event to do. Basically, you just keep on the track, you just drive on the track. It's only about 2 miles. And you just basically go faster than 125 miles per hour. There is really not much else to say. You can see me, I'm crashing. Like I think I crashed twice in this little playthrough. But it is very easy. Basically, all you do is drive straight, and you will get there. Even if you do crash beforehand, it's very, very easy to gain your speed back up because obviously you're in a freaking Agera. So as you can see here, I'm just going to carry on mowing down. I'm going to show you the whole thing because obviously, you know, it is a walkthrough. I'm still coming here, breaking a bit, you know, but still at a solid 185 and across the line. And then obviously you're going to get some XP and you're going to get some credits for doing so. So, yeah, again, it's very easy. I'm pretty sure you could break 200 if you really wanted to. But, yeah, not too hard at all. So the second one is including a McLaren P1. And you basically have to drive to a certain area, I believe, in 2 minutes. The difficulty is medium, and I will say this is a lot harder than the first event. As you can see here, it's in Nice, and it is, again, it's a lot harder than the first event. It's definitely a step up, but it's still relatively easy, you know. It's not too hard at all. I would say giving it a medium rating is pretty fair. So as you can see here, it's telling you to escape to the countryside in your P1. And it's a 4 mile drive with a minute and a half a target limit. So basically, you're just going to have to follow the highlighted route. There is not a better route to follow. You just follow this highlighted route and you should be good to go. And you basically just get to the spot itself. It's pretty self-explanatory, to be honest. Like, some of the actual bucket list challenges themselves do have some kind of shortcuts and stuff you can take, but for the first two, there really isn't that much you can do. You just go and follow, you know, the highlighted route. I would say, if you are trying to do this, don't push yourself too far, because if you are especially playing with a McLaren P1 and you haven't got, you know, stability management control on or traction control on, it really does like to get its back end out. So one thing I would say is don't hesitate with braking. I mean, as you can see here, I am braking quite a bit, probably a bit too much. I probably could have done this this challenge and under like maybe a minute 10 if I really, really just went for it. But that's one thing I would say, you know, is just really don't push the car too far because it will spin out. It is pretty relatively easy. I'm sure you guys can manage it. But anyway, as we are coming to the end of this race, only 500 yards. As you can see, I took that very, very wide there. And we are almost across the line. So here we are, McLaren P1, pretty easy. Obviously, you're going to get some credits, you're going to get some XP. But let's move on to the third bucket list challenge. This one includes a Pagani Zonda. Basically, you're asked to basically fulfill some near misses. Now, basically, there's multiple ways of doing this. You can stay in this kind of little village area in Sisteron, obviously where the challenge is actually held. You can either stay in this little city area and do it that way, or you can follow the highlighted route. Now, I followed the highlighted route just because, you know, it's kind of straight, it's easy to do, basically. Like, if you're in the city, it's easy to kind of bump into things, and, you know, if you kind of want to have that extra XP so you can get some of the skill bonuses, I guess it is really good just to kind of you know, go on the straight route. So basically, here you go. You can see me following the straight route. I actually do crash out at one point, but it is very, very easy. You know, this is another easy event. Basically, you just got to stay close to each car. So you don't have to be insanely close. I would suggest trying to stay in the middle of both the oncoming lane and the, you know, forward going lane. So kind of stay straight in the middle, so you don't kind of, you know, you're not always on one side of the lane. That basically means that if you get a car coming from the left-hand side or the right-hand side, you're going to get both near misses. And if you do follow this route, I believe you'll get, I think it's like 30 opportunities to, you know, get near misses off from cars. So it is really easy. It's not too hard at all. And I'm pretty sure, you know, you guys will be able to do this. Another thing I would say is make sure you don't push the car too hard, because, again, you will crash out. I'm pretty sure I did crash out at one point when I was doing this event. But it is genuinely pretty easy. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. If you do want to see more of these, you know, instructional videos, make sure to hit the like, subscribe. I'm going to have a barn find video out later, so I hope you guys go on to enjoy that. If you do, make sure to hit the like, subscribe. My forum is down below as well, as my Twitter and my Twitch. As you can see here, I crashed out. but I still kept my my combo going, which is pretty cool. Yeah, so all my links are down in the description below as we start to finish off this event. I guess I'll carry on commentating while this event's just finishing. There you go, we've got one, and we've got another one, and then there's two up here, I believe, and across the line. So, again, hope you guys enjoy the video, and I shall see you later. Peace.